We want to make Howard University a university which is quite relevant to the black community. We want Howard not shut off from Georgia Avenue and 14th Street. We want Howard University to stand as a pinnacle of black America as far as education is concerned.
You know, we're talking about Howard University. We're talking about black people. Black people asking for freedom and more rights. We don't care what happens at white universities.
Right. But realistically, how long can you sit in this building?
Oh, realistically, we're going to stay here until, you know, we get what we want. That's being very realistic.
At some point, the university trustees and administration, they wanted to negotiate. They wanted to sit and talk with us to find out what was going on. And so we put together a negotiating team. And the team was headed by Adrian Manns.
And so we were going back and forth on a lot of issues, and came down to two that were a problem. First was Neighbor's resignation. And the trustees told us that he planned to retire the next year, so that they felt there was no need to ask him to resign. And secondly was on the matter of black, the word black. We wanted Howard to make a statement about its commitment to the black community, to the welfare of the black community. And the trustees said no, they couldn't do that.
The takeover had entered its third day. Students expected to be evicted by the Washington, D.C. police, a force that was predominantly white. Despite the bravado, many feared police action on campus. By the fourth day, trustees were ready to take legal action against the students. Clark pleaded with the students to end their protest. He told them the trustees would not accept the students' definition of a black university, but they would give students a greater voice in developing the curriculum.
We talked about it that night, and that morning we got up and we went down and we said, you know, it's time for us to go. And we gave our reasons why we should go. And we asked all the press to leave. We were there and we had open mic so students can come up and they could say whether they were for it, whether they were against it, whatever the reason. That went on for about an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours. We took a voice vote and the agreement was that we should go.
Mr. Brown, will you call Howard a black university now?
No, Howard is not a black university now.
However, is there a possibility that it will be?
We are working towards that end.
Yeah, we have made a major move in our protest to move Howard towards becoming a black university. Howard is well on its way towards becoming the black university, the type of black university we want to see. If we didn't believe that, we would not have come out of that building.
We are concerned first with these young people, the students of Howard University, as human beings, and we are identified with them as human beings.
The students ended their takeover. It had lasted 5 days. Police had not intervened. The following semester, Howard University sponsored a national conference called Toward a Black University. It energized a growing Black Studies movement throughout the country.